Hey folks, it's Rich Mack here, and welcome back to leg number 16 of our Around the World journey, and we are in Cranfield, England, and we are headed to Ostend, Belgium today. Last flight in the UK, we're going to be departing the UK, and we are headed to the continent as I sit here and struggle with my rudder pedals as we taxi really fast also. Hold on, slow down, big guy. So, it looks like we got some pretty nice weather here. It's about 3 o'clock in the afternoon. We've had some clouds roll in, but I am expecting better weather. Jeez, it's really going fast. I'm expecting better weather over the continent, over the channel. So we'll see. Flight plan today is going to take us just north of London. So maybe if we're lucky, we'll get to see some of the London skyline. I am all over. Isaac can't get the rudder pedals right now with this update. Come on. It jerked to the left, and now I'm all over the place again. All right, we'll slowly get back. Let's slowly get back. We're getting close. Let me get in here. Like I said, let me get in here. There we go. It really looks like I'm going fast here. Come on, stay on the taxiway. And there it goes. Oh, it's an adventure. A complete adventure right now. All right, so the plane's all set up and ready to go, except for my flaps, which I need to set right now for takeoff. Come on. Don't get all wonky on me. So I get right out to the runway, and we're going to take off. Not going to be a terribly long flight. A little over an hour. And away we go. Whoa, don't. And here we go. Jeez. Love it. It's gonna snap back. Snap, don't snap. Get off the ground. Force it off the ground if I have to at this point. Goodness. Gear up. Just trim up too. Come on, trim up. Nose up. Feels really dark in here with these clouds. I mean, it's not exactly an overcast day here, but man, it feels dark in the cockpit. Get our flaps up, we'll clean up this airplane. Now, this is going to be an experiment. Engaging autopilot. And, come on. So, let you in a little secret here. This is the second attempt from me to record this flight because the autopilot just went kind of crazy on me the last flight. Let me watch and see what happens here, and then I'll get back to that. And it looks like we're good now. So in the last flight, it kept wanting to fly circles on me, and it was not in roll mode. I was in nav mode, or in, you know, the standard, whatever you want to call it, GPS mode. I guess it'd be nav mode. If you hit the nav button down there, you can actually put it in what's like a roll mode where it's going to fly circles. It wasn't in roll mode. It was in nav mode and just flying circles. So I tried to fix the autopilot, and I noticed that I didn't have a flight director, and I could not get the flight director to come back up. And I don't believe that this plane, or maybe any plane, is going to engage an autopilot without a flight director. So I was kind of screwed. I couldn't get the flight director to pop back up. I was hand flying it for a while, and I kind of thought that really defeats the whole purpose of what I want to do here, because I want to get outside the plane and just look around and enjoy it. And kind of hard to do so when you're hand flying all the time. I just can't hand fly from outside. I don't have those skills. So here we are, doing it once again, and I think we're fine now. Again, don't know why, but sometimes the autopilot just gets really crazy. So I'm hoping that this flight's going to take us close enough we might actually get to see the skyline of London. It's going to be really close. I'm going to hop back in again real quick. Let's zoom out so you get an idea of the flight plan here. So it's going to take us just south, or just northeast of London, down to around Dover, and we're going to cross the channel and head over just north of Dunkirk and go into Ostend. Which, I'm also trying to figure out Ostend. To me, it sounds like East End. But there's nothing to the west of Ostend, really, except for the English Channel. So I don't know if that's really what it means. But anyhow, enough of my is it entomology at the origin of words. Turn off our lights here. Enough of my entomology attempt. All right, let's get back out and enjoy the view now. So I'm going to miss the UK. It's beautiful. Had fun flying across it, but we got a big world to fly around, and now we're going to head over to the continent. Not sure what happened here. It got really stuttery. The excitable part of me hopes that was maybe London loading in, but I don't think so. We're still kind of far away from London. Another golf course. So I'm flying at 3,000 feet, just under this cloud layer. Another airfield. I do not know what it is. And we have some bigger jets parked there. Another thing I really should do is, I lift my throttle at 100% again. Shouldn't leave my throttle at 100%. The sim and this aircraft in their current form aren't going to really penalize you for that, but it's a good way to burn up your engine. Still kind of hoping this cloud layer will lift up a little bit. Oh, too far. Looks like an airfield there. I don't know if it's a grass strip, if it's an old, unused airfield, or if that's, I don't know. We're just going to go down below these clouds. ₹2,500 should do the trick. Maybe should do the trick. Size of that warehouse. Getting closer to London, you can obviously see it's starting to get more built up. That may be the River Thames right there. That is definitely London. Screenshot of London. What I can see of it. There's more in the fog back there. Of course, it's got to be cloudy right now. I don't even know what that thing is called right there. Looks like Pinhead. I guess that would be the Thames Estuary. I do have to say I spent, I think, 1 week in London. That was, God, I think that was almost 25 years ago now. God, I'm old. It was, I think, 1 or 2 months after Princess Diana's death. There were flowers everywhere in central London. They were still all over the streets. They hadn't cleaned everything up yet when we had been there. Big bridge there. If I'm where I think I am, I think that's the M2. And it's crossing it in Chatham. Looks like it has that all drawn in as a grass strip. I don't know what airport that is, but I don't think that's right. So on the map, you got a road network. It has messed up. It shifted it all south. Southeast. Looks like the road network of central London now is right on the Channel Coast. Interesting. We'll be making a turn in just a moment. That's going to be taking us direct to Dover. And we're going to be crossing direct across the channel. Is that a grass strip? I can't tell if that is or not. Here we go. Maybe we'll get to see the cliffs. See how well they are portrayed in the sim. Although since I've never seen them in person in real life, I'm not sure how well or how I'll be able to tell how well they are, but I'll at least see what they look like and let you guys judge. Lots of fields here. I would have thought this area of England would be built up, but it's quite the opposite. Alright, so as we get to Dover, we're going to make a slight turn to the left and shoot straight across the channel. Dover is dead ahead. Wait, I didn't look. What do we got? 4 minutes. 4 minutes to Dover. So this is the final leg of the fifth day of the flight. Day six has a couple of very special legs. Going to be really excited about them. Does the I think the channel comes in over here.
What is it?
Look at it now. I think the M20. I don't know if that's the M20 there. Takes you to the entrance of the channel, which should be somewhere down in that area, I would think. But I don't know exactly where. Can't quite tell what those buildings are there. They look very interesting though. Maybe that wasn't the M20. I don't know, maybe that was something else. Alright, let me focus on crossing Dover here. In fact, I don't think that was the channel entrance or anything down. I think that's a little further down the coast now I look at it. I think that's down around Folkestone, and I think that's Dover right there. I think that protected harbor is Dover. I'm thinking that is a castle or something. I think it's hard to see. I don't know if you can see that there. looking now to see if there's any white cliffs, and I... they don't particularly look white. Or cliffy. It's hard to tell. That might be a... yeah, pretty good cliff there, I guess. Maybe down in that area. Alright. I'm over it. Goodbye, UK. You're awesome. And now we scoot across the channel. That is France. And we're just going to be barely sidestepping France into Belgium. But we will shortly be back into France. Love the cloud reflections off the water. See, this is not exactly the shortest route across the channel. If we don't shot straight across the Strait of Dover, Pas de Calais, we'd hit Calais over there in no time flat. But we're kind of paralleling the not exactly paralleling the French-Belgium coast. Still not a far flight across the channel, but again, not as short as we could have been across here. I just imagine these were very hotly contested skies in World War II between the Luftwaffe and the RAF. Daily, nightly raids and the Blitz. All originating out of France and coming across the channel and mostly aiming for London, although London was not the only city that was hit. Not by a long shot. Of course, these waters were also used, well, many, many times over during the war and even during peacetime. These are, I'm sure, heavily traveled waters. But you had the evacuation of Dunkirk, which Dunkirk is off the coast above my aircraft, somewhere in that vicinity. all those many craft, not just Royal Navy, but civilian craft employed as well, all went across the strait, back over there to England. Although they didn't go directly across, the channels were not a direct shot. Some of them went along the coast and back over, but the British ships couldn't travel on the channels that were close to the coast because they'd be shelled. So they had to go further out to the west, to the northwest, and back in. Away from the Germans. Away from the fire. Made it a longer journey. Getting there. Let's see. I believe Dunkirk is right above my aircraft, right there. That angle. All right, you're Coke, 20 miles off, 7 minutes, and Coke should be very close to. Let's go. Let's get a flight plan here. Trying to get a figure out how it's got me going in. Okay. No, we go back. Dunkirk there. I believe that is the last major French city before Belgium. Nope. A little chop there. Again, the Belgian border is just a couple miles north of Dunkirk. Ostend is just almost dead ahead now. And England is off in the distance, can't even see it anymore. It's gone. The runway is right on the water. Oh, that's why I'm looking at the wrong spot. So it's actually up here. Can't quite see it yet, but let's see where we are here. Some other traffic out there. I am flying with live traffic on. There's the runway. And we're going to actually be approaching from the other side. Mitar is all messed up. It's skipping and it's repeating and it's not giving me the right information. Yep, maybe this will do it. Come on, work. $29.92, a standard. Alright, so standard. I do have live weather on. Looks like a standard altimeter for departure and arrival. Sounds kind of fishy to me. So as you can see by the map here, we're going to circle out across around the airport. Echo Bravo Oscar Sierra, that's the airport at Ostend. We're going to hit Ono. It's going to basically be a big square with left turns. Ono to Oscar Sierra 001 to Skard and Nayan, and then right into the runway. That's all there is to it. I would like to have approached this way and come in over the beach, but the winds aren't cooperating, so we'll have to come in from the other direction. Just want to make sure we're still following the plan. Got a little jumpy there. Very choppy. be a little tricky. We're going to be landing kind of into the setting sun. Have an idea what the view is going to be like on landing. Not the best visibility. The airport has a 10,000 foot strip. Long landing strip. Alright, so from here on out, we're looking at all left turns. Distance there. Bigger airport. I don't know if that's Antwerp. No. Brussels, I mean. Might be Brussels. inside here. And let's get some speed blood off. Make our Lex turn to the left, we'll be lined up with a runway 11 miles out. Sun. Take off flaps. My plane. Yeah, trying to land into a setting sun is more difficult than in foul weather. Well, I mean, visibility-wise. There's just almost nothing to see there. Not for those lights. Gear. Landing flaps. As always, I drifted off a little to the left to get back over on track here. Trim up a little. Lights on, landing flaps, gear down, we're all set. Watch my speed here, a little more speed, a little more speed. The rudders go crazy and welcome to Belgium. Yep, that would be where I want to go right there. Actually, was that where I wanted to go? Well, it got me off the runway. It'll get me out of the way. Flaps up here. That turned out to be a nice little flight. And we are now in continental Europe. Here are some big boys. Gonna pull over here off to the side. Put on our parking brakes. Here we have it. Not that. And beautiful seaside Austin. There you go, folks. We are in Belgium. Hope you enjoyed this flight. That was the end of day number 5. See you back tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. And we're off across Europe. Thanks, folks. See you later.